Hey guys, welcome back to the channel and welcome to another cleaning video. Today I have a cleaning and home updates video for you, so let's go ahead and jump right into it.
Someone who'd never wanna see me hurt, but I was fooled by all your vows.
So in my last video I talked about trying to replace the curtains in our loft area, and I measured, but what I got was shorter than what I needed, and I had to order others to come in. So those came in, and my husband is taking out the curtains that I had in the loft area, and he's taking out the ones that I had in the office too. Those are lace curtains, but I feel like I need something that can shut out a lot of light when I need it to, especially in our loft area. So we're going to be replacing both areas, and I'm also going to be cleaning the office. Right now I need him to bring the curtain rods just a little bit lower, because the curtains that I have the rings, and I need the curtain to be able to go in without crunching at the very top. So he took those out. I have the curtains and I'm going to iron them. And this was when I had the original ones that I got. I got them in white. I didn't like them as much, but we'll talk about it. So right now I'm just going to start ironing the curtains that I have, and then we'll go ahead and put them up.
With your crew, got close with all your friends, but never you. You shut me out and gave me attitude.
So my original plan was to use the gray curtains that I have up here in our loft area, and then I was going to use the white ones in our office. But I changed my mind once I got the white ones, and I wanted to just use the white ones in our loft area. But yeah, we'll see how short those curtains are. I'm ironing the gray ones first because I intend to use them as well. They're really, really long. I used to have them in my downstairs area on the big sliding doors, but my wall upstairs is not as high as my wall downstairs. The wall downstairs I think is like 11 feet, but then up here it's like 9 feet. I think, I'm not completely sure, but I'm guessing those numbers. The actual length for the curtains that I have on here are 105 inches, and that was extremely long, but I don't want to cut them. I just want to use them as they are, and I can probably keep them that way, because who knows when we will move and if I'll need long curtains. So I don't want to mess them, but I want to be able to just use them in a space where I don't have to move them quite often. So after ironing the curtains, I wanted to put up the white ones, and you will see in a moment how quickly I realized that these were not the right length curtains that I need, and they will not work. But I'll leave them up here for a moment as I wait for the other curtains to come in. And I also used this chance to just compare the curtains that I have. I wanted to see what the walls looks like with the white curtains and with the gray curtains, and I ended up liking the gray curtains better. So the white ones were not going to work anyway. I ordered a longer one in a gray color, and we'll switch those once they come in. I have that footage in this video. I'm stepping back to see how I like this curtain, since I've had the gray ones and I also have white ones in my room, and I just wanted to see how the colors tie together to the rest of the decor pieces that I have in this area. And clearly the gray ones looked better for me than the white ones. I have white ones in my bedroom and I like them there, but they just don't seem to fit in this room. So I'm guessing the lighting and the color of furniture that you have in a room can affect how your room looks when you put in different curtains. But the white curtains are 90 inches long. Those are not going to work. They're really short and I just did not like them. And then they also have a back black material that's supposed to help with shutting off the light, which is completely fine, but I don't feel like I needed that heavy fabric in that space. So the replacement that I'm ordering are the exact same color, the gray ones that I'm putting in the office, but they don't have a back fabric, so they'll be able to let in a little light, just not as much, but I can also just shut them and have that feeling of kind of blacked out room. So I'm okay with that. But for now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the gray curtains that I had in the loft area that I was trying out there, and I'm just going to use them in the office because I have this blue couch that goes against that wall, and you won't really be able to see how long the curtains are and that they're hanging too low. And also, I won't be opening and closing these curtains as much. It's just more like a decor piece in here. So those will work fine here. That way I don't have to cut them. These gray ones were 105 inches long. They are extremely long and they're just, I had to train the curtains so that they can lean together. And then at the bottom, they're just down there. I'm not worried about it. It's just decor in this space. I'm not going to be shutting or opening them as often, so they'll be fine in here. And once I put those in, I'll go ahead and I'll start cleaning in this area. It definitely needed to be cleaned a little bit. I spend a lot of time here on a weekly basis. I'm in here at least 60 hours a week. So once in a while, I like to just give it a good clean. And once we're done with that, I will share with you the replacement curtains that I got. I have these two metal frame art pieces that I thought I would love to have somewhere in the house, but they ended up not working. They are too loud. Every time somebody's walking, you hear them tapping on the wall, and that noise just that noise is just too much for me. I cannot handle it. So I'm planning on just donating those. And then these are the stands that we had for our computer monitors. We actually replaced those with the viral TikTok double mount monitor holder, and those things are really good. I mean, you will swing that monitor whichever way you need to, and it's just holding it. It's probably the one time that TikTok got me, and I'm not even sad that they got my money, because I got something that's really useful. You'll see how easy it is for me to move my monitor once I flip sides and I'm wiping my desk. You'll see me just move it around. It moves really easy. And usually when I'm working in the afternoon, I usually have the sun rays directly on my computer screens, and I can just, you know, tilt those monitors really easy, and I'm able to just keep working. Look at the setup that my husband has on this side. One of the monitors is sitting up straight, and then the other ones are about regular sitting. But yeah, you can switch those things whichever way you like, and they work just fine. My computer desk has a glass piece on top of the wood that just makes me really lazy about cleaning this area. I'll just take my Swiffer and I'll swiff it off from time to time, but I don't see a lot of dust particles often. And unless I ask myself the last time that I cleaned my desk, I will just keep going. But I will probably try and make it a habit to just, you know, clean my desk on the weekends, you know, maybe every other weekend or something like that, since I spend a lot of time on it, and I just want to make sure that I'm taking care of the computer and I'm taking care of the screens that I have, just the space that I have. I usually feel like if I take care of the things that I have, I'm able to keep them a little longer, and I'm just grateful that I'm able to even have those things, and the least I can do is just take good care of them and maintain them for as long as I can. And when I'm done using it, then I'm handing off something that still has value to the next person, and you know, just sharing something that is not ruined with other people. So for me, just taking care of what I have goes beyond just, you know, daily use. I try to be very mindful about that. Sometimes so we're texting back, but baby, don't you know I will come around and let you know I'm always coming back. If you watched the video before the last one, we were talking about this two stools, the black stools that I had that I was trying to use in my room, and I couldn't really make up my mind with what I wanted to do with them. I eventually took both of them back, so they're no longer here. So that stool is back. I was using it in here for a moment, but then I realized that it wasn't just working. It didn't look nice. Well, it did look nice in here, but it just didn't feel like that was its space. So I took both the one from Ross and Home Goods back. I took both of them back, and now I'm just back searching for something different. I'm not in a rush to get something since I have the space already set up. I just wanted something a little bit different from what I have, but I'm okay with it. I can live with it. I'm not too worried. So it'll be okay. It'll be okay. I needed to use my duster to wipe in between this seat since it was very dusty, and I haven't dusted that seat in a long time. I can't remember the last time that I did that, but it needed to be dusted. But other than that, guys, I'm going to vacuum in here, and then this will be the last thing that I do in this office, and then we'll switch gears and we will get the gray curtains that came in ready for us to hang up. Something you never needed. What was it all for? I don't know you anymore. We go back, we go back, we go back, we collide. Losing track, even God knows I'm trying. Dangerous, selfish way to love you more these days. We go back, we go back, we go back, we collide. Had the vision, we held on to the tide. To me it was clear, but you lied to me. Now I keep thinking, was I wasting my time letting you into my life? Mm-hmm. You brought out the best in me. We had everything we needed. You put me aside and turn out the lights for no reason. Was it a make-believe? Something you never needed. Alright, so I'm done cleaning the office and I'm going to hang up some towels in our closet. I had asked my husband to go ahead and hang a second towel roll that I had got, since we had one and it seemed like our towels are not able to dry you know, after we used them because they were so close together. So I just wanted to get a second rod and just use that in here. So he was kind enough to hang that since he had his drill up here. And now I'm just putting in fresh towels so that we'll have something to use later on. But I have these rods on my storefront. If you're interested, you can get them. It's supposed to hang two towels, but I like to just put one towel on them, and because it has like the double rod, the towel gets enough air flowing through it, so I don't mind using it, and the space behind the door is just fine. So we hang two of them in here and it works out perfect. You can probably tell from the change of clothes that this clip was shot days later. I had to wait a couple of days to get the curtains in, and then my week has just been extremely busy. I didn't have time to work on this until the weekend, so that's when I worked on it. And you can tell that I still have the curtains on that recliner on the corner. So I'll take care of that too. I'll just put it out and throw it away. I'm not sure if I'm going to be using it again, but I'll put them away for now so that we can organize the space. So right now I'm going to iron the curtains that I got, and then we'll put them in, and they looked so nice. I love the fact that they are light blocking curtains, but they're not completely darkening. So I'm trying to show you exactly what the curtain looks like. It doesn't have the black lining on the back that helps with blocking off light for it to be like completely 100% light blocking curtains, but later on you'll see how when I close them out it shuts off light. There's still a little light coming in, which I'm okay with it, but I didn't want to have one that was too heavy anyway, so this one works fine. I got them from Amazon and they are linked on my storefront if you are interested in getting them, and I got them in a 90 inches long, and I got three packs of them to give me like a really full look in that space, and I love the outcome.
With your friend like you did mine, but you don't matter no more, and I'm not the heartless kind of type. My nemesis, you used to be my nemesis, but I ain't got the time to let you bring me down. I'm done with it, 'cause now I see the benefit. I'm saving so much time.
do this during the day so that you can see how much light can still get through when I shut the curtains. It's not a lot of light and it's completely fine for me considering the space that I'm using these curtains in. So just keep an eye on, you know, the kind that you actually want. If you want one that's completely room darkening, then you might want to go with one that has a lining on the back. I'll probably try and see if I can find a link for the ones with the backing. Well, I actually should be able to have that, so I will link both the white curtains that I took back and this gray ones. And just make sure that you measure 3 times before you buy them so that you don't end up with shorter curtains than you need it to be, and that you're not, you know, buying something that you won't like. So I like how this came out. It is beautiful, and because the curtains look really nice, I have to just go ahead and straighten this area just a little bit so that it looks nice, and I'll give you a final tour of it, and then we will go to the garage and start cleaning out our fridge.
Hey guys, so we finally got our fridge fixed. It's what, like a month and a half shy of 2 years since it broke down. Got somebody to come out and fix it, and now I want to go ahead and clean it. So let's take a look at what it looks like right now, and then I'll come in with some water that has maybe some bleach and some soap, and then I'm just gonna wipe it all down, and we'll use it as, you know, like a space to store other things that we have, so our extra food and drinks. So that's what we'll use it for. So let's go ahead and take a look.
Last night I dreamt that I was with you in the sugar blue waters and your big strong hands, crying out like a baby once I knew I was asleep, hoping that.
So first look on the fridge, it doesn't look dirty at all. It just looks like it needs to be wiped down just a little bit, which I thought would be quick and easy, but then it turned out to be a little bit more than I had expected. There was a spill in here and you can't really see it until you start, you know, going into the crevices to try and wipe down to see that. But I think there was like a Pepsi or something that spilled in here and it drained into some of the crevices and you can't really see it. So once I started wiping down some of the drawers, that's when I saw it and I had to get everything out and just wash everything really well before putting them back in.
Yeah, we never spoke of it. We never did go too far. I just wanted to tell you that you're perfect as you are. A little rain came.
So I started off with a soapy bowl of water that has some bleach in it, and I also had a second bowl with just plain water since I wanted to rinse the rug before I wipe down a second time. I like to always go back in with the rug rinsed out when I'm using bleach. So that's what I planned on doing in here. And I started wiping down the surfaces, and as I kept going, I started to realize that, there's a little bit of some marks here and there, and I was just wiping down as the best I could. But the drawers right under this area that I'm cleaning, that's where I saw the stain that was in there. I'm thinking this has been in here for a very long time since we haven't been using this fridge for almost 2 years. If you were here before, on the previous channel, you probably remember in December, the first week of December, my fridge stopped working and I borrowed coolers to put my food in, trying to get the company to come out and fix the fridge, and it was just a runaround. I ended up just going to Lowe's and buying a fridge that could be delivered as soon as possible. Since it had been a couple of days and we didn't have a working fridge, my husband was out on deployment, so I was panicking and everything was just going south. But it was a very hectic time at that time, and I just rushed into buying a fridge that was available, and we put this fridge out here. So I'm thinking this stain has been here the entire time. And remember, this fridge hasn't been hooked, so it hasn't been running or anything. It couldn't run because it wasn't working. So that stain has been here literally 1 year and 10 months. So it's st still sticky. So I'm guessing the heat in here, I don't know. I have no idea. But when I saw this stain, I was just like, okay, I didn't want to do too much in here, but I guess I have to just do a proper clean. Sometimes I try to cut corners with my cleaning, but somehow something always happens that forces me to just go 100% committed to getting the space cleaned. So that's what happened here. And you can see that we have that thermometer. I don't know. Is it a thermometer? Is it? I don't know what it's called, guys. I can't think right now. But my husband was using that to keep up with the temperature in the fridge because we needed to know if it's actually working. And there was a water bottle in the freezer because we wanted to also make sure that that was working, since the guy who fixed it just wanted to, be completely sure that he fixed it. So a couple of days later, he called us, which was really, really great. He called us to find out if the fridge was working, and I was really excited that he even thought to call and see how it was going. And this man was just godsend. I needed him. He showed up at the right time, and now I have a second fridge that I can use. So cleaning it is the least of my worries. I will take as much time as I need to get it cleaned, and we'll be able to use it for extras that we have around the house that I need to, keep in a space. That way, nothing is going bad. All right, so all the pieces that I wanted to actually wash in the sink are in here, and I'm going to get a new microfiber cloth that I'm going to use on those glass surfaces since I don't want any scratches on them. So I don't want to use an abrasive scrubber or the other microfiber cloth that I have been using since I don't know what's stuck on it. So I'm just going to use a new one to wash down those glass pieces, and then we'll go back and put them in. And this big piece that's closest to the camera had most of the stain on it, and you'll see my husband and I try to fix it. He had taken the kids to the pool, and I just took that time to work on this refrigerator since I knew I wasn't going to get in the water. The water is too cold. It's too cold right now. I am not even trying to be in the pool at this time of the year. So I chose to just stay home and get this done so that I don't have to worry about it for the week that's coming up. So yeah, I'm just washing this down with a soapy microfiber cloth, and then I'm just putting them on my dishwasher to kind of air dry them for a little bit before we put them back in. We had two drawer pieces that we needed to unscrew to get those washed since there was a stain under it, and it was just easier to take it apart and get those cleaned. But then the flat piece that we're working on right now, that was a little bit more challenging since even after unscrewing the centerpieces that kind of hold it together, after unscrewing those, we still could not get the glass off. So I had to figure out a way to try and clean it. And I tried to go in with one of those straw brushes, and that didn't work. The edges were not just getting in. So we just decided to spray some Dawn Power Wash spray on the glass, and then try and pry them open and just run water and have that wash it down. And that worked. I just had to do it a few times for it to actually clean it out, but thank God it was able to do that, so we didn't have to worry about taking it apart. I don't even know how to take it apart now since it's just one piece, and we couldn't figure out how to separate those two. So we just cleaned it the best we could, and then we just set it aside and just let it air dry for a little bit before putting everything back together. Now, I took everything out of the fridge, but I don't know which piece goes where. So my husband is coming in helping me put these pieces back in. So you guys will get to see him a little bit working on this. I know that he's been on this video a little bit more than he usually is, which I'm very grateful for. So I'm just letting you know that you will see him a little bit helping me out with these. I couldn't remember what pieces went where, and he was home, so I just picked his brain and asked him to put them back in for me, and he was happy to help.
Before there are mom swinging trees.
All right, so with all the pieces being completely done, so now I'm going to get a bowl of water, put in some soap, and I'm going to go in and clean the stain. The best way that I know how to do this is just get the soap, get the rug as soapy as possible, and then just keep rubbing until you get all of it off. I find Dawn to be the best thing to use to clean such kind of grime because it just lifts it so easy. So I just had to scrub it a few times with the microfiber cloth because that is the softest that I can use, and it just came off. I did not have too much trouble with it. I didn't have to bring anything that's coarse to scrub in there. And I'm also trying to just be very careful with the fridge. I don't want to have any scratches on it. This fridge broke down less than less than 2 years into having it, because we had it in our previous home, and when we moved, we brought it in with us. So I know that it hasn't had a lot of life to it, and I just want to be able to maintain it for as long as I can. And just using a microfiber cloth is better for this kind of surfaces. So my husband is putting all this stuff back, and he also helped with putting in some of the items that we needed to unpack and put in. So you'll still get to see him load up the fridge, and then I'll come in later with whatever's left and I'll put those in last. Alright, so something that you guys probably never knew about me is that I love Sprite. I don't drink it every day, but when I crave Sprite, it has to be one in a can, and I love it because of the carbonation in it. And it's almost like an out-of-body experience when that Sprite just goes down my throat. It is something that I have loved for a very long time, and every time I take a sip, it just quenches that thirst. You know that thirst for something that's not just plain water? That's what Sprite does for me. So now you know something else about me. And we have some Blue Moon for my husband. He likes to enjoy those from time to time. I'm putting them at the very top so that the kids can't reach those. And then I will put in some water bottles, since we always like to grab some on our way out, and it's just easier and readily accessible for us to grab as we head out. I also have a few other things that I have in here. So some half and half, some heavy whipped cream, some extra milk. I do have some bread and some leftovers that I actually pack and put in my freezer. Now, I have talked about always making a little bit more than I need, and I put the rest in the freezer. We do have a separate freezer in here in the garage too that I put my extra food. So I'm just trying to separate those two right now, and I'm trying to figure out what I want to put in the big freezer and what I want to put in the freezer that's with the fridge. But this is what we have in here right now, and I love having this setup. It's just easier for me to have a little bit extra, that way I don't have to run to the store every time I run out of something. I always have a little extra just saved away. Alright guys, this is all that I have on this video. Thank you so much for hanging out with me. I really do appreciate you being here. If you're not subscribed and you got to the end of this video, please consider subscribing and joining our family. We would love to have you here. Let's get to that 10,000 subscribers, guys. I have been waiting, and I'm hoping that it will happen soon. For now, take care, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.